is a beautiful, crisp, cool, sunshiny afternoon in Iowa City, Iowa. Kinnick Stadium, the Iowa Hawkeyes welcome the Michigan State Spartans. Butcher out of Wheaton, Warrenville South, his second start, and he was a little shaky at the outset last week, but warmed to the task as the game wound on. Take a look at the Iowa skill people. We talked about Liddell Betts. Casper, pretty good receiver, isn't he, Randy?
The favorite receiver of Butcher, somebody that doesn't do a lot of things great, but does everything pretty well.
That's Betts in motion. Again, looks to the air, tight pocket, nice catch, Khalil Hill across the 30-yard line, a gain of about 6 yards. Advance Auto Parts starting lineup as we look to the trenches, and A.J. Blazek in the middle of the Iowa line is not only the physical leader, but the spiritual leader for this Hawkeye team. Butcher again looks to throw, under a blitz, hit as he throws, and a great catch by Hill once again. Underneath the coverage of Ronaldo Hill, it's a first down up near the 43-yard line. Butcher, lots of time. Nice throw, Casper, inside the 15, close to the first down of the 13-yard line. 50% touchdowns in the red zone for the Hawkeyes. Betts, big hole, inside the 5. Close to another first down, and it might be first and goal. They run Betts. First down and more. It'll be first down and goal. No, it's first down and touchdown. Iowa Hawkeyes. True freshman Nate Kading out of Iowa City, Iowa. And the hometown product puts it through the uprights. The Iowa Hawkeyes march to a lead of 7-0 with 7:28 left to go in the first quarter. 5 tough yards at the end of this run to pay dirt, and the Hawkeyes enjoy an early advantage on homecoming weekend.
Derek Pickett started the season as a second stringer, who's developed into a solid contributor now as a starter.
The linebacking core for the Iowa Hawkeyes, Davison Dolezal, a good LeVar Woods, leads this team in tackles behind the line of scrimmage.
And Benny Sapp, making just his second start, a true freshman.
Betts to the outside, cuts it back. Nice move. Betts plowing for yardage, close to the first down of the 37-yard line. Gain of 10 yards. Casper in motion. Play action, Butcher on his own, hit as he throws, got it away to Allen, nice play, guess on the stop. Just third down, about a yard to go. Inside handoff, Allen breaks free, fumble the football, Michigan State recovers. Third down, tight pocket, no pocket. Derek Pickens, the junior college transfer, right up the middle, buries Ryan Van Dyke for a loss of 7. Fourth down, Michigan State.
Talked earlier about Pickens coming into the season as a second-string player, but has emerged because of his outstanding performance and has not only become a starter but a major contributor. Van Dyke stands back there. You got to get rid of that ball right away. Once that first receiver's not there, he's got no time to come off of him and pick up a secondary receiver.
Comes Duckett, and we may have another score here. Sapp in pursuit. Look at the speed of Duckett, and then the power in the end. And they're going to rule him out of bounds inside the one. Third down and goal to go, 2 yards away. The fake to Duckett, Van Dyke to the end zone, and he threads the needle. Touchdown, Ivory McCoy with a penalty marker down.
Well, they called interference, and it was really pretty good coverage the whole way, but a perfect pass by Van Dyke.
And the extra point is blocked in the middle of the line and covered up. The extra point blocked. Jerry Montgomery comes away with it. I'm not sure if he got it. But Bobby Williams not out of the woods yet. The Spartans still trail with 13:15 to go in this first half on the block by the Iowa Hawkeyes of the extra point try by David Schaefer. First down, Iowa Hawkeyes, Liddell Betts.
Liddell Betts, the ball carrier.
Beautiful move out across the 40, gain of 9 to the 41. Kind of a low snap. Baker gets it away. Sean Foster lets it go. Hits on the five. Backs up for the Hawkeyes. And they down it inside the five. Oh, goodness. You couldn't do better with a lob wedge on a wet green than that one. Really. Pass is tipped. Caught by Butcher.
Got to run it. He can't throw it again.
Oh, and he threw it to Betts. Penalty markers all over the play. Liddell Betts dropped the ball, but you're right, Randy. He can't throw it after catching it.
It's already one forward pass. He just happened to be the receiver on it. Completely legal play if he catches that ball, which he did, and runs with it. But the fact that he threw it again, that's where the violation comes in, the second forward pass.
Redshirt freshman says, I should have known that. Kinnick Stadium, Iowa City, Iowa. Overcast now as the clouds have moved in. Wayne Larrabee, Randy Wright, Chris Miller. And T.J. Duckett off to the races. Yanked down by Benny Sapp near the Iowa 40. 23-yard field goal attempt. David Schaefer. And a line drive right through the boulevard. The Iowa Hawkeyes have given their hometown crowd an awful lot to cheer about on this homecoming weekend. It's been a rough sledding for the Spartans in the early going. They got down early, but come back to lead just before halftime. Future play action, naked bootleg. Nice throw. Kyle Trapeer, the tight end, for a first down near the 48-yard line. Flowers, the man in motion. Van Dyke over the middle, intercepted. Aaron Campman. Zone blitz. They drop the defensive end into the passing lane, and he picks it off.
Just a touch pass by Van Dyke. You can see 85, Ivory McCoy behind the defenders, but Van Dyke doesn't get enough air underneath that ball, and Campman makes a very athletic play to go up and knock this ball up in the air, and then enough presence of mind to come down with. There's the knockup, and just enough control over to bring it into his body.
Four receivers set, three to the bottom of your screen, and then run out of it, and didn't fool anybody up front. Right up the middle came Fred Barr to destroy the play and knock down Little John Flowers. Another Michigan State mistake on third down.
You know, that's at least one where you're trying to make something happen.
Another short kick by Jarrett. Oh, it hit a Hawkeye. That's a free ball. Michigan State's got it. Third and short, Michigan State. Duckett going wide. First down and more. Duck it off to the races. Touchdown, Michigan State. 31-yard gallop. So the group making the trip over here from East Lansing, happy at the moment. Even a couple of Packer fans in the middle of that group. Hill. Khalil Hill. Dancing to daylight. Look at this.
Take a look at his individual effort. Not a lot of great blocking and seams, but just a wonderful job avoiding and breaking tackles. And then it's just speed. And sometimes, Wayne, you just got to count on your playmakers to make the play. You saw T.J. Duckett do it, and now we see Khalil Hill put his team right back in this game.
His second career kickoff return for a touchdown, his career long, 90 yards. And Khalil Hill vaults Iowa right back into it.
Just a thing of beauty to watch if you're a special teams coach. Little bit of a seam, excellent moves, keeps his balance, and watch the block he gets right down here. Boom, there's the block. Takes any chance Michigan State has of catching him away as he pulls away going into the end zone.
Roberto Rickards is the man who made that block, Randy, and I'll tell you what, it was textbook. So Kirk Ferentz and company hanging around, trailing by two to the nationally ranked Spartans. Also out on this drive has been T.J. Duckett. Play action. Got his man. LaVale Richardson, first down and goal to go as the Spartans move into position. 17-yard gain. 24-yard field goal attempt. Kick is blocked! It's blocked! Picked up by Woods out of bounds! Across the 15 to the 16-yard line. Special teams nightmare here in Iowa City for Michigan State. Future again, short pass. There's Casper, shook loose and is brought down to the play for the first down of the 41-yard line. Kevin Casper, who came in, averaging 8 receptions per game, gets 6 yards on that one, only his second catch of the day.
And a second down, they've got themselves in a position to win this.
Casper on a comeback. Could not get away from Drew Young, the weak side linebacker who made this tackle near the 49, and it becomes a third down for Iowa at about 3 yards to go.
It looked like this were going to be a lot bigger play than it turned out to be. It's set up well. There's Trupier trying to get in front of Henry and make the block, but it's Drew Young, number 4, who has really made his presence known in this second half.
Second down, Iowa. Michigan State coming on a blitz once again. Casper behind that bubble screen. Casper in the end zone. Touchdown, Iowa Hawkeyes. No flags. 43 yards. And now a late flag, maybe for celebration.
We said earlier, Michigan State shows their hand a little bit earlier, coming with an all-out blitz. Great call. And once you get by that initial wave of pressure, there's nobody back there to back up. No safeties, no linebackers. Good call. Ken O'Keefe, realizing what Michigan State was doing, calls the right play, and it's executed perfectly.
The execution is the key part, Randy. There were 4 blocks on that little screen pass that helped spring it. Celebration penalty. Unsportsmanlike conduct makes this a 35-yard extra point attempt by Nate Kading. Well, Kading, more than equal to the task. Kevin Casper comes alive on this fourth quarter drive, capping an 11-play, 84-yard drive with a bubble screen touchdown run.
You always like that as a quarterback. Get that film off of it, that slick stuff off of it. I used to love to use balls that had been in practice for a month.
Line drive kick, they're not going to give Haygood a chance. Take it by one of the up backs. Quez Wedlow on the return, and he was erased by Demond Sanders and George Lewis. Take a look at it.
Not used to running the ball back. Does a nice job of getting the ball upfield as far as he can, but boy, what a hit. That ought to fire up this Iowa defense. Michigan State takes the field now, knowing they've got plenty of time. They need to just execute things.
But you've got a relatively inexperienced junior quarterback at the helm in Ryan Van Dyke.
That's where it starts. The team is going to react to how they see him.
Out of the shotgun. Good protection initially. Ball tipped in the air. Intercepted by the Hawkeyes. Jerry Montgomery tipped it. LeVar Woods intercepted it. And the Hawkeyes are a minute 54 away from their first win in 14 outings. Facing third down. Off play action, rolling left is Butcher. He's hit and sacked. Roped down back near the 42-yard line. Michigan State will get one more crack at it. 5 seconds to go. This could be it for Michigan State. Last gasp. Van Dyke going deep over the top into the end zone. Incomplete. And the Iowa Hawkeyes have hung on to snap a 13-game losing streak. To remove. have snapped the longest losing streak in school history, and the students storm the field. The Iowa Hawkeyes have upset the 25th-ranked Michigan State Spartans, 21-16. Special thanks to Jeff Nelson, our statistician, for Chris Miller, Randy Wright, Wayne Larrabee. So long from Iowa City.